Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my JavaScript series, and here I'm covering some miscellaneous and very important items in JavaScript. In this video we are going to talk about JavaScript objects. Okay, and particularly on JavaScript objects we are going to talk about object.define property, what all different methods are there, how we can iterate on an object using different methods, what is object property descriptor, how to create a new property in the object, how to create an object. So if you simply say how to create an object, it is simple. We either you can just use a simply double curly braces, or you can just do object.create, or you can actually use create a new object using constructor function like new hello. Hello is a function. These are the different possible ways in which you can create a new object, or like you can create a new object from another object, object.create pass the existing object, or using object.assign pass the existing object, something like this, which we have already talked about. Assign, here we are creating new object and here we are passing the existing object. Similarly, we have like object.assign, you can also use a spread operator to create a new copy from the existing object. Here x is an object and I have a y. Okay, so these are the different possible ways to create an object in JavaScript. So here we are talking about, if you already have an object, how to create a new properties. Simply what we do is, if o is there, then I can just say o.y is 900, right? These are the simple ways we can we append the properties to the object. Okay, now there is one more property, one more method to add the new properties which is native to JavaScript, which is object.define property. Okay, what this object.define property does, it is used in order to make a new property on the existing object. So here O is the existing object, I am adding a test property, and here I'm providing the descriptor information about the property, means the value, configurable, enumerable, writable. These are the three properties which you will define. So define property takes three arguments: object, new property, and the descriptor. Descriptor will have its values, configurable, writable, enumerable. And there is a method on the object, get on property descriptor. You pass the object and you pass the property. So here I can see the property descriptor of this test property on the object. It looks like this. So if you are not, so there are many properties: the values, configurable, writable, enumerable. If you are not passing it, then by default those properties will become false. Writable and enumerable in this case is false, configurable is true. Okay, so this is the descriptor object. In JavaScript, this descriptor object is very important. We have to have a good understanding about this descriptor if you wanted to learn in depth about JavaScript objects. Okay, now if you simply talk about these one by one, these properties, what is the meaning of these? Okay, so configurable, if it is true, like if we see that there is writable false, enumerable false, configurable is true. So configurable is a boolean property. Okay, that is representing a descriptor, right? So there are three things: enumerable, configurable, writable. So if configurable property is true, then this property can be deleted from the object. Okay, enumerable, if this is true, then only you will be able to iterate this object property from object. And writable, if this is true, then only you will be able to update the property. Okay, writable, true, the property may be overridden. Okay, o.test, if I put writable false here, then you will not be able to update this property. You will not get an error, but like here you are doing o.test and you try to override it with something hello, right? You will not get any error, but it will not override it. You will still have the value a, which is here. Okay, so that is when you are making writable true or false. Similarly, there is another property, enumerable. So enumerable, if it is true, then only it will be iterated through foreign object. So there is a foreign is the method using which you can iterate on the object properties and for in loop only iterate if the property is enumerable as true. Okay, and then there is a getters and setter methods also we define in an object. Okay, so we now we talked about what are these particular properties: enumerable, configurable, writable, and configurable. Okay, now there are some particular methods are there. In previous videos also we talked about how to lock an object, how to freeze an object, how to seal an object. So what actually these methods does, what actually these methods will do: object.freeze, object.seal, object.prevent extension, right? So what it does is prevents new property to be added to your object. Okay, so object.isExtensible you can call and check if this object is extendable or not. These three methods are very important: object.seal, object.prevent extension, object.seal. Seal is same as above, and properties cannot be removed. It means you actually freeze it, you actually sealed an object. What it is doing, it is making configurable as false for all the properties. So here object.freeze, object.seal, what they are doing is they are dealing with these three properties, they are playing around it, they are updating these properties. So you can see object.seal is actually updating your configurable as a false. Okay, so this property cannot be removed. Object.freeze same as above, but it is setting writable false. Now I hope you understood it. Writable false means the value cannot be updated in an object. Okay, so these three properties: object.seal, object.freeze, object.prevent extensions, and there are methods to check it if object is sealed. It's sealed, is writable, these are the methods. Object.isFreeze, I guess. Okay, so these three methods actually moves around these three properties. Writable means it's a freeze, you can't update the value. Enumerable false means you cannot iterate onto this value. Configurable false means you cannot even delete that value from an object. Okay, now we'll talk about how we can iterate. So what we do is, most of the time how we create an object is either you create simply const obj empty curly braces and then you can start adding the properties. And here you start adding the values to the object. These are the properties. So if you now say object.getOnPropertyDescriptor and you pass the object and properties, then you will get the property descriptor saying okay, value, writable, configurable, enumerable. By default, these all properties will be true for these kind of objects and properties. So that means you can update it, that means you can iterate it, that means you can also configure it, right? All these things you will be able to do it. Now iteration on the object. So iteration is easy. Here we are using for in loop. For in loop is latest, and what it does, it actually iterate on all enumerable properties of an object. Okay, we are talking about enumerable properties, and those properties can be coming from the parent inheritance. Like you will be extending an object and creating new object. That means you had this object X. So like this is the object I have. Okay, and I'm creating a new object. What I'm doing is object dot, you can say assign. Here I'm creating new object and I'm passing the existing object. It means new object you are creating by extending the proto of this object. It means when you are doing iteration onto this object, it will iterate on all the properties of the object. So new object, if you talk about the properties which this object itself is having, it's empty object. It is inheriting the object, this object, and then adding those properties. That means these properties purely doesn't belong to new object. Those exist in the prototype. Okay, so here we can actually do a check. Object.p.hasOnProperty. If you only want to iterate onto the object properties that object itself is having, not the parent object from where it is created. Okay, So the current property is not a direct property, so it will just check only, run this logic if that property is in the object itself. Okay. Now iteration for the iteration, we have object.keys, object.values, object.entries, object.keys will give you the keys. Okay, keys will be first and last. And now it will be an array. So you can iterate on an array. Object.keys is an array. You can run for each, map, filter, reduce, whatever you want. So similarly, you can also run a for of loop. Once you got an array, you can write for of loop. So object.keys, object.values, object.entries, all these three methods on the object is giving me the array as an outcome. Object.keys will give me the keys, object.values will give me the values, object.entries will give me the key value pair. Right, this one, object.entries, one of the important one. Here I'm getting keys and values both, a simple shorthand method which will help you to iterate and print key and value for an object, right? So this is how we are doing it, and this is a for loop. So these are very important aspects, right? What all different methods we can use to iterate on an object and get the properties from an object. Object dot foreign loop, object dot keys, values, entries, object dot define property, object dot define properties, object dot freeze, object dot seal, object dot prevent extensions. All these methods are there to help us. So object dot keys, object.values, object.entries, object.onPropertyNames. This is another important method. So we were talking about iterating on an object and checking that object.hasOnProperty. Instead of that, you can only run this and you will get only those properties which exist in the object. Okay, getOnPropertySymbols, all these methods are there. So we talked a lot about objects, how to define properties, how to create objects. Okay. What is the meaning of creative, writable, enumerable, configurable? Okay, that's it in this video, guys. Thanks, everyone. Thanks for watching.